Welcome back to Facing Waves. This week, we're exploring northern Saskatchewan in Canada with a three-day canoe trip down the Churchill River with some of the crew from Churchill River Outfitters.
We left from Missinipe and traveled to Stanley Mission, which is one of the most commonly traveled routes on the Churchill, actually. It's maybe one of the most populated routes on the Churchill as well.
The interesting points along the way would be some of the waterfalls we see. We stopped at Robertson Falls for some pictures and some fishing.
My name is Randy Nelson. My wife and I manage Twin Falls Lodge here on the Churchill River. We're about a 5-hour drive north of Saskatoon, and you can only get in here by flying in or boating in. Twin Falls Lodge has primarily been a fishing lodge, but we have some really good paddling waters here for all ranges of skill level. There's a lot of flat water, but we also have a lot of waterfalls in the area and some rapids. So if people want to come play in the water, we have that here as well. She gets more beautiful
every time she's... On this stretch of the Churchill, you don't see a lot of big game, but you see a lot of diversity in birds. So we saw some big squadrons of pelicans. We saw bald eagles all the way along. Lots of loons and a couple of turkey vultures too.
And then the next day we continued on through Mountain Lake, through all those islands.
And then continued towards Stanley Mission and the Holy Trinity Church, which is the oldest building in Saskatchewan.
It's the site of the original community of Stanley Mission, but all that remains today is the church itself.
It's always fun to trip with Dan and Nick, and so it's neat to just experience things with them and through their eyes. We all have our own styles of guiding and of tripping and experience things in different ways.
We've done a lot of canoe trips together. It's a lot of fun with those two. It's easy because they have a pretty good idea of what's going on, and it's just it's a relaxing experience on this trip. There's no big rapids to get in the way, just nice lakes to enjoy.
Paddling through each area has its own stories, and sometimes there are past groups that have gone through, other times there are of the voyageurs when they came through, and the history of the fur trade.
Canoeing and camping is all about being outside and connecting with our environment and with each other and with ourselves. And so the more time we spend out in this beautiful boreal shield place, reconnecting with and connecting with biodiversity of all kinds of with plants and birds and fish and lichens and all the rest of it, the more we seek that out, the more we find it in ourselves. I feel like every time I go outside, I'm a better person. So the Churchill is very easy to move upstream and downstream, east and west across the land and the water. And so it was a really important place traditionally for moving for winter spots to summer spots from community to community. And that has continued through the fur trade and through voyageur history. And it's present today. There are a lot of communities along the Churchill that continue to thrive here in trapping settings or in recreational paddling. And so it's a really neat place for paddlers to kind of transcend that past and present. So we're no longer in Birch Park canoes, but we're still traversing on 1,000-year-old portages in those same spots that people have always portaged for as long as we've been here on this land. And so it's a neat place to share in that history and cultivate a new relationship with it.